"Who is Dorothy?" inquired the Patchwork Girl. "A little maid who used to live in Kansas, but is now a Princess of Oz. She's Ozma's best friend, they say, and lives with her in the Royal Palace." "Is Dorothy made of tin?" inquired Ojo. "Is she patchwork like me?" inquired Scraps. "No," said the man. "Dorothy is flesh, just as I am. I know of only one tin person, and that is Nick Chopper, the Tin Woodman, and there will never be but one Patchwork Girl, for any magician that sees you will refuse to make another one like you." "I suppose we shall see the Tin Woodman, for we are going to the country of the Winkies," said the boy. "What for?" asked the woodchopper. "To get the left wing of a yellow butterfly." "It's a long journey," declared the man, "and you will go through lonely parts of Oz, and cross rivers, and traverse dark forests before you get there." "Suits me all right," said Scraps. "I'll get a chance to see the country." "You're crazy, girl. Better crawl into a rag bag and hide there, or give yourself to some little girl to play with. Those who travel are likely to meet trouble. That's why I stay at home." The woodchopper then invited them all to stay the night at his little hut, but they were anxious to get on, and so left him and continued along the path, which was broader now and more distinct. They expected to reach some other house before it grew dark, but the twilight was brief, and Ojo soon began to fear they had made a mistake in leaving the woodchopper. "I can scarcely see the path," he said at last. "Can you see it, Scraps?" "No," replied the Patchwork Girl, who was holding fast to the boy's arm so he could guide her.
"I can see," declared the Glass Cat. "My eyes are better than yours, and my pink brains..."
"Never mind your pink brains, please," said Ojo hastily. "Just run ahead and show us the way. Wait a minute, and I'll tie a string to you, for then you can lead us."